हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर पूनम चौधरी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश HVMPC कॉलेज रायसी हरिद्वार. एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ओल्ड मैन एंड द सी दैट इज रिटन बाय अर्नेस्ट हेमिंगवे. द पर्टिकुलर नॉवल इज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड इन BS6 सेमेस्टर ऑफ HNB यूनिवर्सिटी. बिफोर बिगिनिंग द स्टोरी ऑफ द नॉवल द ओल्ड मैन एंड द सी, आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट द नॉवलिस अर्नेस्ट हेमिंगवे. अर्नेस्ट हेमिंगवे वॉज बोर्न ऑन 22 July 1899 and was died on the same month, 2 July 1961. He is popularly known as a journalist, novelist, short story writer and sportsman. His economical style had a strong influence on 20th century fiction, while his adventurous lifestyle and his public image brought him admiration from later generations. Hemingway produced most of his work between the mid-1920s and the mid-1950s. He published 7 novels, 6 short stories collection and 2 non-fiction works. Many of his works are considered classics of American literature. The Old Man and the Sea is a novel that was published in 1952. Before beginning the story of the novel, The Old Man and the Sea, I would like to quote a strong statement that is quoted by Ernest Hemingway, that is, a man can be destroyed. A man can be destroyed but not defeated. The very strong message that we need today, in the very time when we are facing crucial disease, COVID-19 or coronavirus. But here I am not discussing about the disease, but I am talking about the strong message given by the novelist through the novella Old Man and the Sea. Besides it, there is too many messages that are hidden behind the story of the Old Man and the Sea. That is, a man does not depend on luck. Luck works. I know luck works, but a man does not depend on luck completely. Luck plays a major role in the story and in our everyday life also. But to a superstitious lot like fishermen, poor luck can seem paralyzing. Anyone can have luck, of course, but not everyone can have determination, skill, perseverance. Santiago knows this and therefore believes in his ability rather than chance. He himself says, to hell with the luck. He himself says, to hell with the luck. He thinks, I will bring the luck with me. He does this by not taking any short trick in his work, as Santiago also again explained that it is better to be lucky. It is better to be lucky, but I would rather be obsessed. Then when the luck comes, you are ready. So now let's start the story of The Old Man and the Sea without wasting our time. The Old Man and the Sea is a story that tells the story of a battle between an aging old man, Santiago, having gone 84 days without catching a fish and now being seen as allowed, the worst form of luckiness. He is so lucky. He is so lucky to be blessed. His helper, namely Manolin, but he is very unlucky because he was not able to catch a single fish since last 84 days. Now, Manolin has been forbidden by his parents to sail with him and has been told instead to fish with a successful fisherman. But the bonding between the fishermen Santiago and Manolin is not only the practical one, it becomes the emotional one. Both of them attest emotionally with each other. The boy visits Santiago's shack each night, holding his finger, gear, preparing food, talking about America and American baseball and his favorite player, Joe DiMaggio. Santiago tells Manolin that on the next day, he will venture far out into the Gulf Stream north of Cuba in the Straits of Florida to fish, confident that his unlucky streak is near to its end. Now, on the 85th day, of his unlucky streak, Santiago takes his skiff into the Gulf Stream, sets his line, and by noon has his bait taken by a big fish that he is sure is a marlin. Unable to haul in the great marlin, Santiago is instead pulling up by the marlin, and 2 days and 2 nights passes with Santiago holding on to the line Though wounded by the struggle and pain, Santiago expresses a compassionate appreciation for his advisor, often referring him to as a brother. He also determines that because of the fish, great dignity, no one shall deserve to eat the marlin. No one is deserve to eat the marlin. Yes, a simple story. Yes, The Outland and the Sea appears as a simple story on the surface, but also a tale with a much deeper meaning, much deeper message, and relevance that transcends time and place. It speaks to the universal truth of a man's existence within this world, where pride, respect, tendency, and dreams fuel a man in his quest to thrive in the face of struggle. It is a story not only of Santiago, it is a story not only of his learned Manalen, it is a story of the entire universe who is struggling. Maybe struggle different types, maybe struggles form maybe different types, but the struggle, it is a story about indomitable spirit of man. Santiago stands as a symbol of an attitude towards life, and his fight with the mighty Marlin offers numerous lessons to all men. And his fight with Marlin offers numerous lessons to all men. On the third day, the fish begins to circle the skiff. Santiago, worn out and almost delirious, uses all his remaining strength to pull the fish up onto its side and strip the Marlin with a hapu. Santiago strips the Marlin to the side of his skiff and heads home, thinking about the high price the fish will bring him at the market, and now how many people he will feed on this way into shore. Sharks are attracted to Marlin's blood. When the shark begin attracted Santiago's Marlin, at first he fears that he cannot defend himself because of his age. He will be unable to catch the fish. He will be unable to fight the Marlin. But before long, he gathers his tools to be used as a weapon and does what he must. When he breaks the blade of his knife in the body of one shark, the fear sinks in again. Now they have beaten me. He thinks, I am too old to club shark to death. But I will try as long as I have the oars and the short clubs and the tiller. He again says, I will fight them until I will die. It means to say, Santiago was not ready to quit hope. It means Santiago was not ready to quit the struggle. He was ready to fight until the last breath of his life. Santiago kills a great Marco shark with his hapu, but he loses the weapon. He makes a new hapu by strapping his knife to the end of an oar to help ward off the next line of shark. Five sharks are slain and many others are driven away, but the shark keeps coming, and by nightfall the shark have almost devoured the Marlin's entire flesh, only skeleton leaving behind. But its tail, its head, and Santiago knows that he is destroyed, and tells the sharks of how they have killed his dreams. Sharks did only not kill the Marlin, they did not gather his flesh, but it is the reason that they gathered all the courage, all the dreams of old Santiago. But still, he was not hopeless, he was not ready to lose his hope. Upon reaching the shore before dawn on the next day, Santiago struggles to his shack, carrying the heavy mast on his shoulder, leaving the fish head onto the bones on the shore. Once home, he slumps onto his bed and falls into a deep sleep. He is still asleep when the boy comes to him in the shack in the morning. He had checked the shack every morning, but today he sleeps longer than usual because the wind had grown strong and the boats weren't left ashore. He checks if the old man is breathing, sees his hands, and starts to cry silently as the hands of the old man Santiago were bleeding due to the attack of the shark, due to the heavy weight of the Marlin. But now on the shore, the boy notices and tries to help Santiago. At the shore, A group of tourists arrive and one woman notices that Marlene's skeleton. She sees, asks the waiter about it and he tries to explain but manages only the words turban sharks. So tourists think that the skeleton belongs to a shark. Only that was the reason that they come to know that the skeleton is of a shark. Santiago drifts away from the pages of this story with exactly the same thing he had when it began. Almost nothing. He cares just not being his money nor success, but it does provide him with a legacy that will endure far beyond many monetary gain ever could have, for he retains his own integrity in the face of great challenges. Not even so, he also gave a message that a man does not quit until he has strength, until he has stamina. Not only physical strength is, the strength should be of mentally and spiritually also, as Santiago puzzles. Thank you.